Hello children, welcome back. I hope all of you must have learned and understood chapter 1 very well. And have you done the assignments very neatly in your social studies notebook? Well done. Today we are going to learn chapter 2, and the name of the chapter is Calendars and Timeline. We are going to learn about Gregorian calendar and the Saka calendar. We are also going to learn what a timeline means and what is meant by BC and AD. So listen very carefully and I am sure you will be able to understand this lesson too. I will be teaching you how to draw a timeline, and when you are doing your assignment, you will have to draw a timeline too. Do it very neatly. Use a ruler to draw lines, and you may use color pencils to make your drawing colorful. But please do not use any sketch pens. Do your work very neatly. Keep reading, keep learning, and keep smiling. Chapter 2, Calendars and Timeline. In this chapter, we are going to learn about Gregorian calendar, Saka calendar, we are going to learn about timeline, and we are going to learn what do we mean by AD, BC, CE and BCE. The first calendar we are going to learn about is Gregorian calendar. The Gregorian calendar is internationally the most popular civil calendar. It was introduced by Pope Gregory the 13th in October 1582. It is followed in most of the countries of the world. This calendar is a solar calendar, which means it is connected to the sun. A common year has 365 days, which are divided into 12 months of different lengths. 11 months have either 30 days or 31 days, but the second month, that is February, has 28 days in a common year. But every fourth year, an extra day is added to February and it has 29 days. So this year is called a leap year, and this leap year has 366 days. So in Gregorian calendar, a year has 365 days, and every fourth year is a leap year, which has 366 days. Now the year 2016 was a leap year. Now you add 4 years to that and we get 2020, and this is again a leap year. And all of you must be remembering that this year we had 29 days in February. So this year is a leap year. Now we move to the next calendar, that is the Saka calendar. The Saka calendar is the calendar based on Saka era, and it is the national calendar which is followed in our country. This calendar was adopted from 22nd March 1957, and the Government of India uses the Saka calendar together with the Gregorian calendar for the official uses. Whatever official uses there are, we use both these calendars. Now the dates on the Saka calendar correspond to the dates of Gregorian calendar. And what relationship is there? Every year, the first Saka month, that is Chaitra, begins on 22nd March, according to Gregorian calendar. So when we have 22nd March, then begins the Saka calendar. That is the first day of Saka calendar. And in a leap year, we have one day earlier. The calendar begins one day earlier, and the first day of Chaitra falls on 21st March. And the Saka calendar leap year also has 366 days. So we'll come to learn about the relationship between Gregorian calendar and Saka calendar. Now these two calendars are related, we have already seen. One relation is in the date. Now the Saka era or the Samvat began in 78 AD. Therefore the years in the Saka calendar are counted from 78 AD of Gregorian calendar. So how will you understand that? Let us take one example. Now this year it is the year 2020, and this is according to the Gregorian calendar. Now if we want to know which year this is according to Saka calendar, we have to subtract 78 from it. And when we subtract 78 from the Gregorian year 2020, we get 1942, which is the year according to the Saka calendar. And the first day will fall on 21st March. Why? Because we have leap year this year. So on 21st March 2020 begins the Saka year 1942, and the first month is Chaitra. Have you understood? Now we come to timeline. First, let us know what is meant by BC and AD. So the letters BC stand for before Christ, and the letters AD stand for Anno Domini, which means in the year of the Lord. So the birth of Christ is considered as the focal point, most important point from which we count the dates. And if an event happened 100 years before the birth of Christ, we say that event happened in 100 BC. And if on the other hand anything happened 100 years after the birth of Christ, we say that it happened in 100 AD. So you'll understand this better when you see a timeline. So now we'll move to the drawing of a timeline. You can see here there is a straight line drawn with arrow, which is an arrow. It is moving in both the direction. And in the middle of the line we have year 1, which is considered as the birth of Christ. So this is the middle of the timeline, and towards one side, which is moving towards future, we have AD dates, and on the other side, which is moving towards our past, we have the BC dates. So 100 years before the birth of Christ comes 100 BC, 200 years before birth of Christ comes 200 BC, 300 year before comes 300 BC, and so on. Similarly, anything which happened 100 years after the birth of Christ will be called happening in 100 AD, then we have 200 AD, then we have 300 AD, and so on. Right now we have 2020 AD going on. So when we draw a timeline, we will have to draw a straight line. In fact, we will draw a straight arrow. In the middle, we'll put the birth of Jesus and mark it year 1. In one side, we'll put the AD dates and we'll mark it 100 AD, 200 AD, 300 AD, and so on. And on the other side, we'll put the BC dates and we'll mark it 100 BC, 200 BC, 300 BC, so on. And when we look at the timeline, we can know that 300 BC happened before 200 BC, and in AD, 300 AD happens after 100 AD. So 300 AD will come after 100 AD, and 300 BC will come before 100 BC. So next we come to the concept of CE and BCE. CE stands for Common Era or Current Era, and it is a calendar era that is often used as an alternative naming of the Anno Domini era or AD. Similarly, BCE stands for before common era and is also used in place of before Christ or BC. So with this, we come to the end of today's video tutorial.